Welcome again to everybody. I think we've got 50 plus attendees, mainly customers from all over the country. So thanks for sparing the time. We have got some very important updates to deliver, and we just thought, given everyone's very busy right now, it's December, this will be the most efficient way to deliver the update. And the good news is, to start with, is this is about as much as you get of me. So I'm just doing the introduction, and the presentations today will be delivered by Sam, who's on my left here, Sam Cockerton, and Bradley Foster. They're going to do the product update. And we're going to start, though, from Worcestershire, where we've got Andy McFarren waiting to update us on where we are with our Easy Connect application. So we've got quite a lot to cover. We're going to do it within an hour, so we should be done by 2 o'clock at the latest. I'm sure there's going to be questions, and there is a facility on Teams which I'm monitoring to field questions, and I'll go through the questions at the end of the presentation. I think that's the easiest way to handle questions today. So go ahead and ask questions by all means, and I will garner them, gather them, and address them if the presentations don't deal with the questions. So I think without further ado, we crack on, guys. Yeah. So over to Andy in Worcester. So welcome, Andy, and off we go.
Thanks, Roy. It's a welcome to the webinar from me. I'm here to introduce an update for our Easy Connect software. So many of you probably will remember the first iteration of the Easy Connect software. And what we've done this time around, we want to basically take the ideas of simplicity, a quick and easy, simple way to get a price, which was the kind of the idea of the initial software. And we've just improved on everything that was a potential challenge in the last piece of software. So what we have for us, what we are actually aiming to do here is to create something that's a simple sales tool that's offline for the first phase. We're going to have a managed phased additions to the software to increase the usability based upon the feedback that we get from 7 launch partners, which we're going to be working closely with to try to improve this product and get it to a point where it's at the best it possibly can be. So if I move on to just the next slide here, I can show you that the ideas that we're going with are a sort of visual simplicity, and the idea of the tile system we're keeping, which is just to bold out a few of the improvements upon the existing software that we had previously. And we're going to be creating ourselves something that will hopefully help all of you, our customers, sell to your customers. The idea is that we're going to be creating a professional sales tool here, which is just going to allow you to increase the amount of sales that you're able to make. And we're even generating brand new looking reports, which are going to be nice, clean, simple, fresh. Hopefully you're able to, you know, perhaps if you have an air printer or something, you can go out on site and you can even print out a report as you're building the windows for whoever it might be. So if we just have a quick look at the Easy Connect software. I can just show you how it looks at the moment. So we've had a completely new refresh of all the color scheme, so that we've lost the old greens, and we're going for a nice simple tile system, something clean. And as you can see, we've gone with a product types based system rather than you choosing the product of that listers sell. Obviously the product types that you'll be wanting to choose are, for example, windows. So if we go into here, we can then see we've got the designer range aluminium, our new designer range aluminium, which we are hearing more about in a little while. And we'll be able to have all of our other existing products in here. You can see we have the four options on our website and in our marketing brochures, so the types of frames and the sash, and along with the fixed lights to match. So if we just select one here, then the next option we'll get to see is a new sort of way that we're going to be processing the types of the style of the window, if you like. So you can see at the top there, we have lots of different numbers. The first number is the number of squares wide, followed by the number of squares high. So this is going to be a little bit easier on saving you having to scroll through all this. But as you can see there, there's a little button for you to show everything. So if we just choose a nice simple style here, then you can see we've redesigned the colors so that it's nice and clean and simple again. So it's designed to make it easier for you to see what you're going to be choosing. There we go. We can choose a little inside color. It prompts us. So now we'll choose white, but perhaps you want to see what that looks like. So then we can bottom left corner, see what it looks like on the inside. And we can even say, choose a different color. Let's go with, great. There we go. Great. So once we've processed the colors, we're just going to go straight into designing the actual window. So we're putting the sizes in. Some indicative sizes are going to be what you'll be doing when you're selling. There we are. And we can even then choose a sill if we wish to, but nice and simple. No complicated options here. Then we get on to the glazing. Now, glass is a big, long list for anybody to choose from. And when you're trying to make a sale, you want something clean and simple. So we've gone with some little icons here on our little text tiles, as you can see. Little hammer to show that it's toughened. We've got a little Secure by Design logo to show that it's laminated. And we've even got some little Energy Plus logos where the most energy efficient glazing is. So if we just blow one of those up, you can actually see. There we go. So it just gives you a little description of the actual piece of glass that you're using there too. Once we've done that, we can then select a pattern. And you can see the available patterns that we're able to choose from here. This will change based on the types of glass that you've chosen and the types in the previous pane there. But also we might wish to choose a pattern just on the bottom pane. So now we're able to tap on the bottom and we can actually choose, let's choose the same piece of glass there, and we'll choose another pattern. Here we go, Canterbury, lovely. Now you can see we've got a little warning at the bottom. We're going to be guiding these warnings so that they're able to facilitate a nice, easier pick for you. So there you go, you can see that that's a premium price. So you're able to understand that that's going to be a bit more expensive. And perhaps we might want to add an astral bar in there. And we're able to resize the grids. Perhaps we can put something in there. The idea of this is that you're able to just configure the kind of window that the customer is looking for. And perhaps we would like a LED, maybe, there we go, in this window. Perhaps even a diamond, and we're able to also remove the different pieces of lead work or Georgian bar by just tapping on the picture. Nice and quick and simple. So here we go, we're back to the handles now. So sometimes you're able to see lots of different options for handles, but we've kept this nice and straightforward. So you actually choose your handle type first, and then as you can see, you get all the different colors. You can then flip it onto the inside view and you can just tap through to show the kind of handles that the customer might be required. There we go, we can see which one they prefer. The idea of this is that we actually are increasing the sort of speed that you can show people how things look. So you can see, there we go, the actual antique bronze looks quite good. So we'll go with that one. And we've tried to keep things nice and simple where possible, because of course, as everybody in the industry knows, a window is actually quite a complicated beast. We want to try and make it as simple as possible to get that sale. Here we go, we're going to put a little vent in there, and you can see it draws it on the actual picture on the outside as well as on the inside. There we are. That's it. Great, we've spent some time and we've actually put that window on. We can actually go back to any of the parts that we want to see. There we go, we can see all the options that we've chosen. And then we can tap on anything to go back. And perhaps there we go. We'll add in a location, bathroom, because we have an obscurity at the bottom. There we go. Great. So what we're actually sort of trying to do here with this software is to try to use it as best we possibly can to try to make it as simple as possible to get that sale. So now we have some sale details. We can enter your own customer details if you already have an account on the cloud. So you're able to, you know, if you've already got all your customers on there, we'll be actually able to select from that list. What we're able to try to complete at this point is everything for the actual customer. You can even go away, have your sales guy go away into the van, and he can be typing all this stuff out. And the idea of keeping the white colors is to kind of keep it light and bright rather than the old green, where it was sort of hard to see certain options. This will try to keep this nice and simple. There we go. Spelled cottage wrong there, but that's okay. So we're going to okay this. And now we're going to just accept the order. So it's as simple as that. So we've entered the details, we've added some windows onto the job, and now we're going to just accept the order and just to show you how quick it is. Great, so then you can share a little quick, we've got front page there, frosty windows, keep frost outside. And if we have a look down here, there's a nice little covering letter, as well as basic options that we've selected on that window. And we're still in the process of configuring this, and we're going to be reviewing it with our seven launch partners before the first quarter of next year, so that we're actually able to get a proper product which really benefits users. There you can see, we're going to sign it as James Jones, perhaps it's your husband. Great, and then we can sign on screen. Lovely. Now, just talking about the reports for a moment, what we're actually looking at doing is perhaps putting some terms and conditions on there. We can even have this with your terms and conditions on, and your logo, of course, will always show. But also, you can see those accreditation symbols. We'll try to get those so that they match your company. As you can see, it's put the signature at the bottom. So now we can click print, and it takes it into the Apple menu here. And you can just have a quick review of what it's going to print. And you can export using the little square button. And at this point, then we can save it to your files onto your local device, or you can email it to yourself at the office or something, or perhaps your sales guy can send it over to the people in the office to process. And there we go. So the idea is that we've got a nice little sales tool which will help us help you to sell windows and doors. As simple as that. And without further ado, I'm going to hand over now back to you, Roy. Thank you.
We're on. Okay, Andy, that's a great update and very good delivery. And you kept to the schedule, which is fantastic. 15 minutes, well done. I know it's difficult. It's really exciting. I know a number of customers who will be tuned in now are eagerly awaiting this software. Like all software projects, it tends to elongate ever so slightly, but you know, the effort that's gone in over the last 6 months is absolutely fantastic. So thanks, Andy. I know I speak for lots of customers that we can't wait, can we, for this software to hit the ground. And we're just months away from it now. Honest. We're months away from this. Just to quickly reiterate, we've got a Q&A, so you can start a discussion on this Teams app. We can see the questions coming in. There are no questions yet. Rob Waller, maybe just ask one just to make sure it's working, and then you can. I'll text you back. Hopefully, everyone can hear us. I did get a message from Wayne just saying turn your mic up, but I think we are on maximum bore, so hopefully everybody can hear us. Okay, and. So now I'm going to hand over to Stan Cockerton, who's going to talk to us and start the product update presentation.
Cheers, Roy. So we've been waiting for a while for it, and it's a very exciting addition to the design range, aluminium. But we've finally launched a prestige lift and slide patio door. We've had a lot of success with the bifolds and had a lot of, and which have been selling for quite a while now. And so it's great to have that alternative option for larger openings. So what I'll do for now is we're just going to watch a quick video, which is just going to sum up the main features and benefits with just a little animation, and then we'll just talk through a few of them. So hopefully that came through all right with everyone. So with the lift and slide, there's probably two main categories in terms of features with it. And there's a lot of focus around one, compliance. So we're currently in the process of undergoing PAS 24 testing. Part L compliance for double glazed, you can achieve 1.4, triple glazed 1.0. And what leads quite nicely onto the next point, which is to do with aesthetics, is that for Part F, obviously, it's a big thing at the minute is having to put trickle vents in products. What we have with this product is you can put trickle vents through a 25 mil frame extension. So obviously, probably people are thinking how it'd work is that the trickle vent on the external face would go through the 25 mil frame extension. And then how the product's been designed is that the airflow would then travel through down into the top of the outer frame and out. So you've got allowance for your plaster line. It's quite a big thing for this product, because obviously a common thing, especially with patio doors is that you think, well, you need to put trickle vents in it. You've instantly got to put a 50 mil frame extension to the top, which really bugs out the frame and reduces your glass. So leading on from that, you've got very slim sight lines, so 106 mil frame to dash sight lines. And on twin track configurations, you've got the option to go down to a 52 mil slim interlock. Which obviously with this product, it's all about maximizing glass and really opening up your phone to light. So the product really achieves that. Just a couple of other things as well. It's available in kit form, which is obviously really important for sight access. And then we've also got low friction coatings on gaskets for extra smooth operation. So yeah. But that's not it for the designer range. So just moving on, we've also just launched the Classic Heritage Door, just to complete the Classic range. So again, we're going to watch another video. So that's the Classic Door. Again, with the Classic range, we've been waiting for a while to have something in form of doors. A lot of time in the past, people that wanted Classic would then have to put a Prestige door with it. And obviously then you create any consistency with sight lines and the overall look of the products that you've got. So the beautiful thing with this is that it uses pretty much all of the components and profiles that are in the Classic window range, which means that you get exactly consistent sight lines. It's the same outer frame options, so you can still have either the slim 35 mil or the intermediate 48, and you can mix and match between them, which could be very good in terms of having a door where you need a 48 mil outer frame, and then would want a lower threshold. So we then have the 35 mil threshold at the bottom. So you've got the new dummy transoms and lockbox, which are effectively the only parts that have been added to the Classic range for this door, hence the consistency. This is why you still get sight lines as low as 60.5 mil frame to sash. That's with the slim frame, or with the intermediate frame, then you can get 73 mil. So still very slim. As with the rest of the designer range, Part L compliant. So double glazed, you can get 1.4, but window energy rating also achieved A+. So again, another exciting thing. I think there's a lot of, we've obviously had a large product offering for the designer range for quite a while. We've sold a lot of bifold, obviously Prestige windows and Classic windows have been around for a while. And I think at the minute it's quite an exciting time for designer range, because what we're actually doing is we're plugging the gap, the things that people want. And there are obviously limitations to certain products where customers may want more, but we have very good relationship with the systems company that supply these products. So we take on everyone's feedback and we'll just continue to make improvements. So moving on, this is probably the most exciting one for me in terms of updates on designer range. So we're introducing, it's coming soon, we're aiming for the new year, but we're introducing a designer range entrance door. So just to give you a bit of background on it first, this is quite an important one because a lot of the time I'd have customers come into the showroom and they may potentially bring their customers. And sometimes they come in and they particularly want to look at the designer range, aluminium, or they might come in and they're not sure or they're set on something else. But then they see the aluminium stand in the showroom and they decide that they want to go down that route. They go through, they talk through all the options that they want. And then it comes to the end of the conversation where they're really happy. And then they say, what about the front door? And it's, for a while, it's been an awkward question because obviously people often want more for their money when they're going down the aluminium route than a panel glazed into a stash. But also with aluminium becoming more domesticated, especially with this range, a lot of people aren't willing to go down the route of a bespoke or a specialist aluminium entrance door. So what we wanted to create was an answer to that question about what about my front door, which is something that fits in the middle. So what you've got is you've got the shearline aluminium outer frame, which obviously matches the rest of the designer range in terms of the finish. And then we use a Dorco composite door slab, which everyone will, those that buy Gallery 44 composite doors will know as the urban door slab. And obviously it has a smooth aluminium-like finish to it. And we will then color match that slab to suit the aluminium out front. And obviously people might think get a little bit concerned with that of how the finish matches. And to be honest, before we started testing it, I was. But pretty much instantly getting samples in from Dorco have been brilliant. We managed to mix the paint to exactly match the shearline colours. So any matte finish from shearline can be matched on the slab. Obviously that's providing the concept and the door there, but we still needed to add some value to it and give some more contemporary features to the product that obviously will help our customers sell it. So what we've done is we've added to the range new contemporary glass options, but also added some new hardware choices because most our current Gallery 44 composite door range is very much based around the traditional style door with a lever handle and a lever pad handle, whereas these doors you're going to expect bar handles and clamshell locks, that sort of thing. So we wanted to widen that range. So I'll just go through a little bit more about in detail. So a few of the designs obviously already in the current Gallery 44 range that people recognize, so the Urban Augusta Long, Urban Seminole 4. But obviously we've widened that range, which includes new designs such as the Oakmont, the Augusta Long 2, or the Copenhagen. And with that, as you get on the Urban doors, it comes with a standard flat stipple cassette, which are a perfect match for the slab. We've also added something a little bit different. For a few times in our history of dealing with composite doors, we've explored a couple of options with steel cassettes. So we had a steel cassette where there were sharp corners on the edges, and it was a little bit, it wasn't the ideal solution. And then other times we looked at things where you had an inox door, but which had to be bonded. The cassettes had to be bonded to the door, so it was a bit of a nightmare for unglazing on site. And glazing, obviously, that causes problems. You've got to send the slab back and get reworked. So what we've looked at as an alternative option is we can supply a stainless steel frame, which is really thin, less than a millimetre, and we can bond it to the top of the Dorco cassette. And what that means is that in terms of deglazing, glazing, nothing's changed, completely new. There's no major cost because it's just a steel frame sticking on the top. It's not a complete new cassette. But it gives you the effect of the stainless steel look. Or we can have it powder coated to a textured black finish. And another good thing with this is that the stainless steel frames and the powder coating for the textured black is done exactly by the exact same supplier and in the same factory as where all of the bar handles and escutcheons come from. So everything is bang on exact match. So just a few more of the glass designs that we've added. Just to change things up a little bit more in some contemporary designs. But because the designs that we've got, the glass sizes for the most part are already in the Gallery 44 composite door range. A lot of the glass that's already in the Gallery 44 range, which still would be suitable for this style of door, are still available. So everything is an extra. This isn't a new limited range. Everything's added on from what we're doing on Gallery 44 composite doors. So just a little bit more about the furniture that we've added. So obviously currently in the Gallery 44 range, which would be available for this, we have just regular round inline brushed stainless steel bar handles with escutcheons and finger pulls. Now what we're adding is rectangular brushed stainless steel bar handles, but then also textured black round ones and textured black rectangular. So a nice broad range to suit any taste. The escutcheons and finger pulls can also be matching identical as well to the textured black finish. Obviously, we've gone with textured black because it's rather than smooth black, it's a lot better in terms of for longevity for the customer. Instead of showing up marks and things like that. So we feel that'll appeal to homeowners. But then in terms of hardware, so locks, hinges, cylinders, what we wanted to do at the start of this was try and create a product that it used as much from our Gallery 44 composite doors as possible for reliability and consistency. So if you know how to adjust the lock, adjust keeps for Gallery 44 composite doors, then you know how to do it on this. So it's all about consistency. So we're not changing too much. We're giving an option without completely rewriting it.
Emma's asked me to add that it's going into our designer range brochure, which many of you have already got access to. So we'll add the designer door to the designer range door to this. It's also going into Easy Connect as well. So like every single product that we manufacture, everything will be available in the new software too.
Yeah. So thanks for listening. I'll pass you back to Roy.
Am I going to do something now? Am I?
You are.
Yes, to me.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
We're going to speak for 30 seconds.
I'm going to talk for 30 seconds, am I? God, blimey.
Right, yeah.
Over to Bradley. He's going to update on other bits and bobs.
Thank you very much, Roy. So, leading nicely from Sam's point of the aluminium composite door that we're embracing is the Gallery 44 range, which is an existing brand of ours, which has been going for well over 5 years now. And to be honest, it's gone from strength to strength. And we made some improvements, upgrades, changes to the range back in July, which I wanted to just let you know again about. You may have seen some of it in e-shots and things like that. But we made some updates to the range, which included some new glass. We changed suppliers. We kept all the existing offering that we had before, but we had some new contemporary options. But ones you may have seen from other suppliers, such as Victorian Border and Trio of Diamonds. You can see them on screen there. They're quite contemporary and now some of our biggest sellers. We put some new hardware in there. We also harmonised the hardware between Stoke and Essex for that consistency. So we could put all the right names in the brochure. We've got a premium doctor knocker. We've added pull knobs. We've got suited furniture, so the letterboxes will match your handles. And we've got colour matching options across the range. And then also we spoke with Dorco and made sure that we were selling the most popular slabs that they were selling. So we've actually added a new design in the Belfry 3 to the range, which was in Dorco's top 10, along with the Monza 2 Augusta, so we're getting some demand for that as well. So overall, there's some new things in there on the product side. And to go along with that, we also thought we'd better help you sell them by doing some marketing aspects as well, which we've done an order form, which we'll come on to later about what more we've got to offer from that point of view. There is a paper price list. Roy won't want to hear that. He wants everyone on Easy Connect, but we know that some people still like a paper price list option whereby we've got a grid when we can discount to your discounts, do an uplift if necessary, so that's an option for when you're on site. The new brochure, which a lot of you probably already seen, which has got all the new glass options in, the new hardware, probably opening it up now. That's got big pictures of doors on each page, hopefully showing some of the most popular glass designs that fit in the door, which will hopefully help the homeowners pick what they want. And then finally, we also did quite a bit of work on a new door designer, which is on our website. Feel free to ask any of your sales guys for the link. That's worked out really well for us. It allows you to put the options which aren't in the brochure into real life. You can superimpose them onto your house, your slab, your frame color, your slab color, your glass design, your hardware options. So rather than having to tell the customer to imagine based on the brochure, they can actually look at it on screen.
And everything's going to Easy Connect, of course.
Yes. So following on from the door designer on our website, there is an option to personalise that door designer, put it on your own website. It does come with a small cost of £45 a month, but it's only adds up to about one door a year that actually you need to sell, which we think is a fairly good offer. There's no pricing in there at the minute, which is going to come from Easy Connect, but there's different options of ways that we can design the door and be able to brand it to your company with your logo and put it onto your website so you receive all the leads. So just a reminder that if you've got any questions about what Sam said on aluminium or about Gallery 44, feel free to pop them in the Q&A and we'll try and answer them at the end. But for now, I'm going to move on to talk a bit more about Kubu, which I'm sure you've all heard about. You know that we've been speaking about this for a little while. Just wanted to reintroduce and re-remind everyone of this. And for that, I'm just going to do a quick teaser video to get started.
Gary, stop dancing now.
I get dressed.
Put your clothes back on. You can't keep a good man down, honestly.
So that was just a little teaser about Kubu. So Kubu have won some brilliant awards this way, double award winners at the NFA and the G Awards. And the conversation we've been having with Avantis Kubu over the last, we've been dealing with them for many, many years. Gary, how many years?
I think it's
Gary Bristow was born.
Three decades, I mean.
Long-term partnership. And the conversation we're having is getting some smart-ready products, but the same great quality hardware that we've always had, sweeping that hardware across the full range and summing it up with a security guarantee. So the next few slides are going to tell us a bit more about that.
I think that's really important as well, that we're trying to make it, we're making this product work on every product that we supply. So Kubu will be everywhere. So on Residence, on Sheer Iron Aluminium, on Halo, on Eurostyle, on doors, on bifold doors. So it's important if you're going to start, you know, demonstrating the benefits, decent benefits of Kubu, that it works on everything. What you don't want to do is a salesperson having demonstrated this product is and then be very apologetic because it doesn't work on that product. So Kubu has to work on everything, all the door locks, the new door locks that Randy's going to talk about shortly, the new spam shut lock, Kuba will work on the new fans shut blocks. Easy for me to say. So I have to work on everything.
Exactly. So we're going to watch a slightly longer video now. For those of you who don't know exactly what Kuba is, it's going to explain what it does.
How many times have you thought, have I locked my door? When you're dashing out of the house, sat in an important meeting, or when you've been out for a run. We've all been there. Now with Kubu, you'll never have to worry whether you've locked your door again. Kubu uses smart and simple technology to monitor your lock in real time, alerting your smartphone when you leave your home without locking the front door. Using the simple Kubu app, you'll be able to check the status of your door wherever and whenever you like, receive real-time notifications when anyone enters or exits your door, and schedule notifications for specific days and times. Share doors with your loved ones. Check back through your door history. And ask Amazon Alexa about the status of your doors. The Kubu Smart System is easy to install and takes just minutes. Plug in your home hub, place the module into your existing Kubu-equipped door, and download the Kubu app. Say goodbye to uncertainty and hello to peace of mind. With Kubu, you'll always know the status of your door. Kubu. Be sure it's secure.
Okay, so the video probably does it far better than what I can, but in summary, it's a peace of mind smart lock. It's easy to install. It will integrate with your Google and your Alexas and all those sorts of things. It will give you smartphone notifications for weather, pollen, geofencing as you walk away from your house, all sorts of those alerts. And one thing the video didn't mention is it can even give our homeowner customers a reduction in their home insurance premiums if they've got this installed in their properties. So this is what Kubu does. Kubu, as Roy said, is going to be, we're trying to get it into every single one of our products, and it will be in every single one of our products. And one of the latest changes to get it into our windows is in Stoke, where we have introduced the cam lock, which is a floating mushroom S-bag lock with bi-directional cams. And it's got all the security accreditations, PAS 24 testing and the like. This is now being processed on new orders in Stoke, where it will replace the TSL lock, and it is Kubu ready. So all your doors have been Kubu ready for quite a while now, a couple of years or so. And this is going to be the windows in Stoke on the Vika standard casements, which is going to be Kubu ready. Were you going to say something, sorry?
No.
So this lock is also available in Essex. Some Essex customers know of the S-bag lock, and that too will be changing to be Kubu ready in the new year as well. So all of our S-bag locks across Stoke and Essex will be the cam lock, which will be Kubu ready. So that is an S-bag lock, and the claw lock, those of you in Essex will probably recognise this. This is a bi-directional hook shoot bolt lock. So it's got shoot bolts either end and two hooks in the middle. It's the only one on the market. It's exclusive to listers. And this lock is the standard lock that you'll be getting from Essex. Those customers in Essex would have been having this since spring, but it hasn't been Kubu ready. But from the new year, this lock will be Kubu ready. So all of the standard window locks across the group will be Kubu ready from the new year. This claw lock as well will be being developed to fit onto Timeless and Residents and the whole product range and Shearline as well in due course. There's some technical stuff to get right in terms of the keeps and back sets and things like that. But in due course, this will be across all Lister's products.
Yeah, over the next 4 months, we'll see it on all products. Yeah. And it will be available. So it's either cam lock or it's claw lock. Yeah, customer gets to choose.
So just a bit more about claw lock. I'm going to let the video drill into some of its USPs.
Today we're introducing the hook window lock, which has been designed to work with Kubu. And this Avantis high security hook window lock not only meets the industry standards, but exceeds it. It's actually tested to 4.5 kilonewton as opposed to the 3 kilonewton required, and is cycle tested to over 100,000 cycles. This premium window lock uses a combination of high strength materials to achieve the best performance possible. This window lock is the UK's only bidirectional hook centre gearbox. The advantage of bidirectional hooks is that it resists anti-lip loading. The UK's largest centre hooks on a window lock provide unparalleled levels of security when engaging into the keys. The security hooks are designed to match the Avantis multi-point door lock to provide a suited range of security hardware. And now for the clever bit. This is the first shoot bolt window lock on the market, which has been designed to work with Kubu. This provides homeowners with security information about their windows and home that has never been offered before. So all the homeowner needs to do is go online, order the smart window sensor, and they get a whole host of smart security features.
So just as that video was playing, we were just discussing here that just a reminder that all these videos are available to be branded with your company logos. If you want to put any of them, that's the Shearline ones, the Kubu ones, that we can put onto your website, brand them up, put your logos in them, similar to what's been done for us by Kubu here.
And all the new brochures that Emma's compiling, so doing lots and lots of new updates on brochures. We're using those new lock brands, Camlock and Clawlock, all the way through it as well. So Camlock works with Kubu, Clawlock works with Kubu.
Perfect. So as Roy was alluding to earlier, we need to get Kubu into all of our products. Now, getting it into everything can be a little bit of a challenge in the lock. For example, patios and bifolds often require a systems house specific lock that's a bit more unique, that isn't as readily available. So to get Kubu into that product, we can put Kubu in just the cylinder, so that then the cylinder acts as the Kubu sensor and can tell you whether your door's unlocked or locked and all of those things that will pop up on the Kubu app. As well as that, we've got the Auto Fire composite door lock, which will be coming in the new year. Both of these items aren't ready just yet, but it will be quarter one next year, where we can put an Auto Fire lock on either a lever handle or a slam shut lock. For the composite doors, that will follow over to the designer range entrance door as well. And each of the latches on that lock is independently triggered, unlike on some of the other slam shut locks which are on the market. So a quick video on that lock. So next year we will have all of the products Kubu ready, and what that allows us to do is to offer a security guarantee that covers all the products, the locks, the cylinders, even some of the handles will all be from Avantis Kubu, and it means that we can offer a suited security offering, which can then be backed up by a security guarantee across all the products that you can see there, the windows with either the cam lock or the claw lock. All of our doors have been Kubu ready for a number of years already. The auto fire locks on the Gallery 44 and designer entrance range door, and obviously the cylinders, which can be put in bifolds and patios and even retrofitted into existing products in customers' houses if you needed. So that sums up Kubu. Just a reminder again, we've had a couple, but if you've got any questions, pop them in the Q&A section and we will visit them at the end. And I'm just going to run through a few final points. None of these will take long. But they're just some updates that we've had internally over the last few weeks and months that I want to let you know about. So firstly, we've got the Residence Collection Astrical Bar. So some feedback that residents got, and they've introduced this product, which is an aluminium strip which sits behind the Astrical Bar, which gets taped to the window, which should stop that smile effect that sometimes you get on the Astrical Bars where they slightly droop in the middle. So this aluminium strip should improve the quality of that, and it fits with the various bar types you can see on screen there, and also means that changing the bars, if they were to damage or for whatever reason, should be far easier than having tape stuck to the whole window and the bar at the same time. Sticking with residents, some of you would have had this product already, but it's the trickle vent, concealed trickle vent cover. So this fits on both the R7 and the R9 system, goes on the head of the window, and as you can see in the photo, pretty much makes the trickle vents invisible, which obviously on a high-end product like Residence is quite an important thing. We're all used to seeing a trickle vent on a cheap PVC white window, but on the Residence system, people often want to keep the aesthetics clean and neat and hide those trickle vents under that cover. So that is available to order from us with any Residence order. So sticking on the hidden trickle vent theme to comply with part F, which we've all got to do now, we've been working with Shearline to develop a concealed ventilation cover, which clips onto the top of the Prestige outer frame. So this this also acts as a head drip, and it works with a grill underneath, clips on the top of the frame, and we'll hide the triple vent slots. We've got a small sample here, if anyone can see that. It's very neat, it color matches, clips on the top of the window. Unfortunately, we're still working with Shearline to develop something that will work across a full Shearline range. But this gets a good option for all Prestige windows. And again, with aluminium being high end, you may want to hide those trickle vents behind something for the aesthetics. Order forms, survey forms, we've been working on these for over a year now. It takes far longer than what you'd think. There's one for every product now, except for one, which I've forgotten, but it's every product within our portfolio: Shearline, Vika, Timeless, Residence, Eurocell, and flush options, Modus. That was the one which we haven't done yet. Modus is the one we haven't done yet, but those order forms are available. They're on our website on the product pages. Taking that to the next level, if for any reason you wanted to customize them, we can change colors, we can put your logo on the forms, and we can even make some minor modifications, space permitting, as long as we keep the other options on the page, to put survey notes such as floor to fill height or installation type or trims required, and we can fit them on the order form. And we can customize that for you if you want, if you're interested in that sort of thing, contact us, work with us, and we can get that sort of thing working. So that's everything from me, and I'm going to pass back to Roy to conclude and go to the Q&A.
Yeah, I mean, I've just answered the question, actually. We are working on all products and finding vent concealers and drips, better solutions. Like everything, when you're working with systems companies, it takes longer than you'd like. But we are working on covering all products with vent drips. We're hoping we should see stuff in March, April time from the systems houses that we deal with. So look, thanks again to Andy and Sam. I know it can be quite daunting doing these kind of things when you're speaking publicly, and Bradley, you've done an absolutely sterling job there. Hopefully that has been useful to everybody who's been on today's webinar. Before you go, we are going to offer the opportunity for cute questions that can come through on the chat, but we haven't got many. So just to, if they come in whilst I finish this sum up, in late January, early February, we're just talking to a couple of people who are guest speakers who we think might be helpful to come and address everybody at customer events. So we're trying to find locations and the right speakers so we get some value out of the customer event. So more probably sales and marketing orientated speakers than we've had in the past, just to make sure that we're all ready for the challenges that 2024 will no doubt offer. That's it. There's no questions coming through. So a couple, is there?
Yeah. So the first question on here is just a bit of a time frame on the designer range entrance door. As Sam alluded to, we've done a lot of the testing, we've done a lot of the prep. We're finalising the IT work now. So it will be quarter one next year.
Yeah, there's
the early part, we're hoping.
Yeah, there's quarter one next year is definitely worth it. I'd say really, hopefully the early part, but obviously we want to make sure it's right. There's been a lot of testing that's already gone into it, but we're at a latter stage now.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Right, definitely. And another question that we've got on here is obviously with that range, we kind of flirted some square bar handles and some black bar handles out there, which naturally leads to the question of can we have them on our standard Gallery 44 competition?
Yeah, look, anything that's been, that's the beauty of having the two ranges. Anything that's in the new designer range entrance door can be used on Gallery 44. In terms of hardware, absolutely fine. It sort of coincided. I mean, we had plans anyway to look to add black furniture because I mean, especially when we were walking around like the fit show, for instance, there's just everywhere now. It's become really trendy. Especially that's why we've looked at doing like the black cassettes and things like that. But I mean, any of the new stuff that's just like, you know, attached to the door slab is fine to go on the Gallery 44 range. And it'll all be set up to process and everything.
Let me just mention here that we've got 23 how-to videos that we've been compiling over the last couple of months, and they'll be available via our website in January. So how to deglaze a shear line window, how to do bifold installations, lots and lots of stuff that we've been working on for months with our service engineers. Wayne, can we use the R7 hood drimp on Halo Flush? Apparently not, Wayne. That's why we're working with Halo on getting something that fits into the back of frame on Halo. Same with Uracell. Any other questions there?
I'm clicking through. I think that is it on the list. So unless anything pops up in the next few seconds, that's a wrap.
Okay, well, I'm sure that we'll see you before Christmas. If not, then have a fantastic Christmas, guys. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for listening to our first webinar. And we will all see you shortly. Okay, so thanks again, guys. See you.
Cheers, guys.
Bye.
See you later.
Thank you.